Hello, my beautiful spirits. How are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna. Thanks for stopping by. And this is a Gemini love check-in to see what's happening. Welcome, everyone. We have your overall energy and message from spirit that you are about to make a very powerful move. We have a lovely chess piece with wings. Guardian angels are here to protect your energy. We also have the Divine Matrix. This is all about synchronicity. It's about you trusting spirit to let things unfold and bring what you need to you at a given time in divine timing. So you're very tuned into spirit right now. You're just letting everything unfold on its own, seeing beyond. Look at that third eye chakra. I spy Gemini. You're very psychic right now, especially so. The energy of the reading that you're bringing in with your love partner, person of interest, is a Justice card. Being very balanced, that's Libra energy, trying to be very fair. I like this energy. It's all about honesty, truthfulness. It can mean a partnership that results or thoughts are circulating between you and your partner about what it would mean to be in a committed relationship. The Justice card, Libra, rules the seventh house on the astrology wheel, which is any kind of partnership in which there is a major commitment with legal bindings. So it can be it can be anything from a birth certificate, marriage license, you know, any paperwork that we need to buy homes, anything like that. The energy of you and your partner at this time is that you're feeling very protective of your relationship. Both of you, I'm going to read your energies as a twosome all the way through. And we see the two of you being very protective. There are many, many outside energies, and these are jobs and people and responsibilities and people that might be interested in dating one or the other of you, but you both of you are in this very spiritual place with your relationship. It speaks very strongly to the fact that you're both defending the relationship and you're really not interested in anyone else. It's really like, no, namaste, I'm all good. Both of you are in the energy of Aquarius energy. Seven of Wands is the energy of, it's not Sagittarius, it is Leo energy. Okay, sorry about that. Every now and then, my brain doesn't work as quickly as I'd like. But we have the King of Swords energy, Aquarius energy. And what we see here is with this Aquarius energy, that your person and you are very calm, cool, collected. You know, you're chill, you're happy, you're content. The birds mean that you message each other, you talk very, you have your own language. I would even go as far as to say that with those birds as messengers, the two of you speak a special language with each other to your heart space. The Five of Pentacles is bringing you into the reading. There is a part of you that's really missing your person. It looks like you're both really busy, and it speaks to the fact that both of you know that you could spend or would love to spend more time together, but you feel sort of like locked out of having more time. The Hanged Man speaks to the fact that both of you are looking at things from a different perspective. You're juggling the idea that right now the relationship is not really bound or, you know, committed. You're both in the next 6 weeks will be staying in this energy of, you know, leaving it like it is, both of you come and go a lot. I'm not seeing this though as player energy, and I will tell you why. Because when we look at the tarot cards, every card must be, it's part of a tapestry. And in this tapestry of love, I'm seeing two people who absolutely adore each other. You are soulmates. You both feel this. You both feel compelled. You're both thinking about long-term. You're both being very cool, calm, and collected. You're both holding back right now with each other. But it says that there's a lot of heat. There's a lot of passion. But what I see here is that you're at a crossroads. The Five of Swords says that, you know, you've been through your difficulties and challenges like any relationship. That, you know, there was probably even a time when you may have broken up or had a period of time of anywhere from 5 weeks to 5 months, that things just didn't seem fair, that one of you may have hurt the other. But with this soulmate energy, and this energy of trying to make a decision. Both of you want to protect the relationship, but we have two twos here. So one person might have other commitments. It could be commitments to parents, it could be commitments to children, it could be commitments to, you know, a serious relationship that came about long before you entered the picture. But, you know, you have to take it as it resonates. And, you know, this is oftentimes and more often than not juggling two jobs or lots of responsibilities. The Two of Wands speaks very seriously to the fact that the two of you know that a decision will be forced upon both of you at some time in the future. Both of you, again, are in this energy of sort of letting things unfold, trusting spirit. You're both very intuitive. I would actually say that you have psychic energy between the two of you in terms of your moods. So let's go ahead and clarify this. I really like this reading. It is a very, I think, honest reading about where you're at this time. But the love is very sacred to both of you. Neither of you want to give it up. And I think the question that is sort of lying in wait here is if you'll be forced or feel forced to give it up because of other responsibilities. So let's see what we have. We have the Seven of Wands, feeling very protective, feeling very like holding back, not really talking about this energy. I really think the two of you are absolutely adoring each other, in love with each other, and I don't think you're talking about it, but you both understand. You both understand that you're not speaking about it. The Hanged Man energy, you're trying to look at things as a couple, individually, within the coupledom, of, you know, trying to see things from a different perspective. The Four of Swords says that being apart sort of wounds you. When we look at this energy, both of you feel a bit pessimistic about if this can come together, but the Four of Pentacles is repeating itself. Neither one of you are going to let this go in any shape or way that is of willingness. So you both are very much in this energy of wanting to continue to protect this relationship. The King of Swords energy, both of you love this relationship. Both of you feel incredibly gratified. Six of Wands also speaks to the passion that's so honest between the two of you. It makes it very passionate. You can make love all night long. You never tire of each other. You could be together 60 years and you wouldn't bore with one another. But the Six of Wands is Leo energy. You know, that's the house of romance on the astrology wheel. Both of you are incredibly attractive to other people, but you choose to be together, and look at what fell out. Okay. Innocence of Wands is clarifying this Five of Coins. The way that you really act when you're together is throwing caution to the winds. You're both aware of not being able to spend enough time, but look at that energy. You both embody this abundance of love for one another. Empress energy, you nurture one another. You absolutely love to be together. You prize that energy. It is Taurus energy. And the Innocence of Wands is Sagittarius energy. When we look at the Hanged Man, that is Pisces energy, searching for answers, trying to look at things in a different way to see if you can come up with a different solution. Spirit of Swords, again, King of Swords, King of Swords. You're both staying very, very aware of the surroundings. When we look at the Black Panther peering out, you know, among the leaves or the honeysuckle, whatever. It looks like actually dragonflies. It really speaks to the fact that you watch this relationship very carefully. You know, you want your time to pounce. You want to have your opportunity to have this relationship. You're not sure when it will be. So let's see what the Two of Coins is up here. What are you juggling? Movement of Cups. Well, you're juggling your romance. You're juggling, you're trying to see if you can move it forward. It means that you're highly romantic with each other. The Judgment card says that, you know, again, you feel as though this day is coming that you're going to have to make a choice. Judgment is releasing something, so it does look like one person would have to give something up. Again, you know, they would have to, you'd have to release something. So Two of Coins can be, you know, releasing the judgment card can be releasing anything, a thought, a place, a person, a way of doing things. So the Two of Coins says that the way that you're juggling your love life right now is requiring a decision, lots of it. The Justice card with the Judgment card with the Two of Coins will indicate for some of you, not all of you, but for a few of you out there, will indicate that one of you must leave another relationship behind. And justice is usually the filing of divorce paperwork. Judgment is usually the final dissolution of marriage. So it does speak to the fact that both of you are very serious about this relationship. And it's a tall order, right, to do that. When we get the Knight of Wands here for your near future, we see that nothing's going to change in terms of how things are at the present moment. The Hermit card says that when you're alone, you think of each other constantly, that, you know, the Knight of Wands is fast moving thoughts. So during the day when you're moving around doing your work, because the Hermit is Virgo, it's your day-to-day work responsibilities, it really speaks to the fact that you have fleeting thoughts of each other all the time. Your thoughts about each other are very geared to how much fun you have, the laughter, wanting to be together, wanting to spend time together, trying to figure out when you could carve some time out of your busy schedules to be together. You know, that soulmate energy is very powerful. Gemini energy, there you are, Gemini. You are in your reading. So let's see why we have the Four of Pentacles here. Why is it here for us? Oh my gosh, you want a new beginning. You want to take that leap of faith with each other. You want to just let yourselves go. You want to leap into that beautiful soulmate energy. The Spirit of Cups, King of Cups. Both of you are very well. You manage your emotions very well, as we can see when we look at the King of Swords. But both of you feel such a depth of emotion, Scorpio energy. Neither one of you feel as though you'll ever have a relationship as good or as intense or as sweet as this one. Why do we have the energy of the Five of Swords as your big fear? Five of Swords is when life makes you make choices you don't want to make. The Ace of Wands. Ooh, I like that. The Ace of Wands is all about forging forward, a passionate new beginning, investing in the relationship. It speaks to the fact that Heart of Swords, Queen of Swords, King of Swords. So both of you will make rational decisions because the situation is unique, but it does feel unfair. You know, why? What is it that was unfair here? What makes you fearful? The Spirit of Pentacles, the Daddy card, obligations, you know, money issues. You know, oftentimes when families come together, you know, in a second marriage or whatever, it looks like there's worries about money. Would there be enough to take care of everybody if that were the case? For some of you, again, it won't resonate with everybody. The Two of Wands energy, why is it here? What decision will you have to think about making in the near future? Movement of Wands, well, whether you're going to, okay. So whether you're going to stay in this playful in and out energy or whether you're going to end something that will be deemed as a betrayal. Yeah, Seven of Wands, you're both defending your relationship. So you both still feel it. You have to defend the relationship. You feel as though, you know, you don't know whether you have to end this relationship. Now, I would say for some of you, I'm going to caution that Spirit is saying that this, if it is a private relationship that you, in which you don't want others to know, it may become known. It just may become known. So, but let's see, why is the Ten of Swords here? What is it that would have to be, seem like a stab in the back? Nine of Cups, happiness. So what I'm seeing here is if the two of you cannot finish the relationship or end something else, if this relationship has to come to a halt and you have to give up this passionate, beautiful relationship, both of you, you'd do almost anything to keep the relationship. Movement of Wands. It speaks to the fact that you don't want to be, you don't want to end this. You'd run away. You'd try to find another way. But why is the Ten of Swords here again? Yep, your twin flames. There you go, 11-11. I don't think the two of you can really bring yourself to do this. And yet, You know, there are situations around you that are requiring you. You know, if you want your happiness, it looks as though it's a very tough situation. One person looks as though they're very devoted and very loyal to a family, which, of course, everybody should feel that way. But the Wheel of Fortune will turn in your favor. So that is your divine timing. That is your divine matrix, you know, allowing spirit to do that. So right now, Gemini, you look like you're absolutely in this intense, incredible period of time in which both of you are feeling exactly the same thing. And you both know it. There's a very strong understanding that you both feel this way. So we will see what we shall see in the long term, right? It is evolution, not revolution, and relationships are a process, not a light switch. So sending you love from Chicago. Hope to see you soon in another reading. Please let me know where you're from. Tell me what you think of this reading and tell me how it resonates. Thanks so much. Bye-bye.